Our big story tonight, from public servant to jail inmate. Former Anne Arundel County Executive John Leopold is now serving time in jail, even though prosecutors had suggested a suspended sentence.
Yeah, the judge said a message needed to be sent for misconduct in office, so Leopold left the county courthouse in handcuffs today. 11 News iTeam reporter Barry Sims was in the courtroom and joins us now live from Annapolis with more. Barry?
Well, it definitely is a surprising end, especially since prosecutors did not ask for jail time because of Leopold's age, he's 70 years old, and because of his health. Also today, the defense filed a motion for a stay of the sentence. The Maryland Court of Special Appeals denied that. Once the powerful leader of Anne Arundel County, now John Leopold, is a prisoner in the county jail.
I'm angry at the judge for what he did.
Carol Vittick is a supporter and former employee of Leopold. She's upset that Judge Dennis Sweeney sentenced the former county executive to a two-year sentence, suspending most of it, but still sending Leopold to jail for 60 days. He can't be released for 30 days. If he is compliant, he may be allowed to serve the remaining month at home under house arrest.
Didn't even give him the dignity of going out of that courtroom without the handcuffs. Handcuffs. I mean, he's not a, what you call a bad criminal. Jesus, this is awful.
On January 29th, the judge found Leopold guilty of misconduct in office for using his security detail while on duty to do work on his campaign and for having his secretary empty his catheter bag following his back surgery. She claimed she did it because she feared for her job. Defense attorney Bruce Marcus argued that Leopold was humbled, chastened, and profoundly remorseful, and also resigned from office. He asked the judge to consider Leopold's 44 years of public service, both in Hawaii and here in Maryland. Leopold told the judge he regretted and was ashamed of his actions, saying, quote, "For my irresponsible failures in judgment, I am sorry."
It was a great feeling to see Mr. Leopold go out in handcuffs.
Former Leopold employee Joan Harris says Leopold ruled by fear. She feels vindicated by the sentence.
I think it sends a message to all elected officials, whether you're a Democrat or Republican, you cannot abuse your power and get away with it. You will be held accountable for what you do.
In fact, the judge said he was trying to send a strong warning. Without mentioning any name, he cited the case of former Baltimore Mayor Sheila Dixon, who was also forced from office. She was given probation. Judge Sweeney decided he needed to send a stronger message of deterrence, saying if you violate the law in this area in a serious way, you will be handcuffed, led from a courtroom, and spend time in jail. State Prosecutor Emmett Davitt believes some will get it.
Well, it does send the message. I would never go so far to say that everybody's going to get the message.
Now, Leopold also received a $100,000 fine, but the judge said that he will consider accepting $75,000 payment if it goes to the county. And Leopold was also ordered to perform 400 hours of community service, and he cannot run for office while he is on probation for 5 years. Reporting live from Annapolis, Barry Sims, WBAL-TV, 11 News.
Barry,